Good Sunday morning, everybody. Live and direct from downtown Memphis, Tennessee, I'm meteorologist Austin Onick with a look at the rest of the weekend forecast and, again, going into next week, Mother's Day a week from today. Possibility of showers and thunderstorms back in the forecast. Not for today. Looking good as we go throughout the rest of the Beale Street Music Fest. And, of course, for the rest of the area today, patchy fog burning off, otherwise decently quiet across much of the Mid-South. Again, for Sunday, later this next week, could be signs of some stronger weather heading our way. We'll talk more about that coming up here in just a little bit. Heading out to the Beale Street Music Fest, things are going to be looking a lot nicer. It's a little gray this morning, but as we get into the course of the rest of the day, should be, again, some very pleasant conditions, minus the umbrella across much of the area. Now, through the rest of the day, high pressure is going to be making its way on through. That's bringing in drier air to the Mid-South. And as that drier air sweeps its way in from parts of the Plain States, we'll look at less cloud cover across the area. So that'll help out for at least for today. Now, that area of low pressure that we saw, again, that's brought us all those showers and, again, some thunderstorms back to our south and east yesterday, that is going to be making its way across the country, dropping down across Florida and making its way into around the Atlantic and the Gulf. No major problems there, but we do have another storm system making its way down from the north to the south, and that again could drop some chances of showers and thunderstorms north of us. And then we also have a new storm system developing across the Rockies heading into the Plain States. That's going to stir things up as well as we get into the later portion of this next week. So not looking too bad for right now. But as we get into the next couple of days, again, we have to watch out west to see what heads our direction. Storm system, again, not seeing anything in the way of problems for Memphis as we go throughout the area for Sunday, as most of the threat of severe weather is going to be, again, back into the Plain States, the Rio Grande, and back up into the Missouri River Valley. Into Monday, the potential, again, stays back to our west, but starts creeping a little bit closer to us as we get into around the I-70 corridor and then back into parts of Kansas, Missouri, Oklahoma, and Texas. That, again, if you're heading that direction, will be a bit of a threat. We do see that potential of, again, some generic thunderstorms north of the Mid-South coming up by Monday. And then as we get into Tuesday, threat becomes a little bit more pronounced, again, back to our west. And late on Tuesday, we could be looking at the potential for some more widespread thunderstorms late during the day, early evening into Wednesday morning. And then the threat for severe weather could be a bit of a problem as we go into around Thursday. And that threat, not on this forecast that you're looking at here, may, again, overspread much of the Mid-South area. And again, too early to tell exactly what we're going to be looking for. But if we are seeing things like this, again, the slight risk category back to our west now, that's a good sign that we're going to see some more active weather heading our direction as we go into the course of the next couple of days. So definitely something to pay attention to there. Rest of the forecast, again, partly to mostly cloudy early, then clearing out, but it's going to take a long time to get rid of all that cloud cover. And temperatures back in the lower to mid-70s as we get into the forecast for later on today. Comfortable, pleasant, dry, beautiful across the area for later on. So if you have any plans for outdoors, go ahead and keep them today. Looking good across much of the area for Monday and Tuesday. We'll have more on that forecast coming up for you on News Channel 3 on air and online. 55 days until Asteroid Day. It's an internationally recognized day to promote asteroid awareness, and it's on the day that the blast happened over Siberia, Russia back in 2008. We need to be more aware of what asteroids can do to our planet and how to track them, and we need more mathematicians and engineers and astronomers to keep an eye on stuff like that. We'll talk about that coming up later on today and tonight, so stay tuned for more on that. Catch my forecast on Country 92.5, Oldies 102.3, and of course I'll be back on with Bob and Josh tomorrow morning at 6 a.m. with your complete forecast on AM 730 and 1600. Don't forget, again, now the time that nothing is happening is the best time to get ready for severe weather. Know where your safe place is. Get some fresh batteries in your weather radio. Do not just depend on tornado sirens for your severe weather alerts. One of the best ways you can do so, again, sign up for Weather Call with Tim and Jim. They will call you. You give them their phone number. You give them your phone number and your location, and they will automatically call you to let you know when severe weather may be happening. So that's a good way to stay safe. And again, now is the best time to get prepared for stuff like that. Stay tuned for more throughout the rest of the weekend for more details on your forecast. I'm meteorologist Austin Onick. More weather available at wreg.com/weather.